We were building our case.
Okay.
We are building our case. There were confrontations all along, and then minor people are growing. So we told you here that we are not reviving. So we are building something that we are going to leave it to our four kids to come.
Okay.
So we are building our case to be strong. People were discharged with in the party. Mwiongo was expelled. Understand the word expel. What does that mean? He had no choice. He was told, leave the door. So, what we are doing now, we are building our case and we are petitioning the United Nations. They have to listen to what we are saying and they have to follow. So, we are imposed to things. So, we are saying no. Our no is no. That's why we are calling for a referendum that should be instituted in Caprivi.
Do you think that you will succeed in this? You are building and someone, you are building someone's house, and then that someone's house says no, don't build my house.
Will it's you not will somebody's house. Building the we house? Are not doing somebody's house.
The government
we
now
are
is
building
for
our own house.
The government now is for swapo. They are majority. They are the one who are ruling this country. So will you think you will manage to build if they are saying no, we don't
want. I think there you are a bit wrong when you say the government is for swapping. We are partners. The president told you here that this is a marriage. Whether your wife is working or not working, she is entitled to get a portion of the share. We are entitled. It's our right to get benefits from the existing government. We are not begging, we are not pleading, it's our right to get what belongs to us as Caprivians. Whether we never joined Swapo, we merged with Swapo. Get the point. We were not dissolved. If you look to our records which we have clear records where late Greenwell Matongo said we will never join Swamp. We remain CANU. These were his words.
Mr. Kulobone, the problem now is on the merger itself. That is the problem. CANU and Swapo merged and then they formed one party. I heard that no, thing.
It's not yet.
It's so not that's what it is saying. That
do you know that?
I don't know whether it's a different document
no,
which
it
I'm
is.
Having.
Do you know that type of writing? It is called inadvertent writing, because it's not. You see, you will find that when they drew that press statement, they say to fight relentlessly for Southwest Africa and Caprivi. And somewhere they omit Caprivi, and somewhere they put it.
Yes.
Somewhere they omit it, somewhere they put it. That is bad writing.
Okay.
That is bad writing.
Mm.
Yeah, he wanted to comment. Before I comment, I wanted to comment on something.
Everybody must comment here.
Yes.
Before we reach him, then let's hear from the Secretary General.
Maybe he will forget.
I think he has been quiet for so long now. I interviewed him in 2000 and...
Maybe he will forget.
I will forget.
Please.
Oh, sorry. Okay.
I think the
let's
time
hear from
is for,
the Defense Secretary.
It's the time for Caprivians now to arise.
All right.
During the struggle, people were threatened. If you talk about CANU, it's either you will be arrested or you will be killed. So even in 1989, people when they were coming here, they were still having that threat to raise CANU, you will be either killed or arrested. One reason which fulfills that is, as Mr. Mwongo was expelled,
I
even
am,
now,
I am suspended.
he feels that Swapo and Kamwi are not together,
because
the president is suspended from the association just because he's the president of Kamwi. So if Swapo and Kamwi merged, what is the reason, or what is, or why is it a threat for somebody to talk about Kamwi? Kamwi and Swapo, is it not the same thing? But today when you talk about Kamwi, it means you are against the government. It's already a sign which shows that Swapo doesn't
recognize
Kamwi.
Not acknowledging.
So does not exist at all.
And Caprivians,
yes,
we must wake up. We must only not consider the forces which we have given in government. The region is being divided. Tomorrow you will see Vambo, we are coming here. I will state that specifically in Kabango. Many people from, in fact, in Mbambo, Chief Mbambo, they are heading cattle and even to these bushlands. Later you will see this area. It's already occupied that they don't have grazing. Which Mr. Mwanangombe has been saying in his meetings during UDP.
Even though we are not UDP,
I'm just referring to what has happened. I am quoting what has been Mr. Mwanangombe saying and what he's coming to say. The name change
is gone.
It's gone. Okay. The name changing is not taking the land, but now, what makes me, if it, Kavango is too big, why is it bigger than other portion? To add to the big region, you cut a small region, a small portion you put, you give the big region. You see?
Full of resources.
Yeah.
There is time on that side.
Yeah. So that is the science of Caprivians to wake up now. To start standing on their own, they must not only think about jobs that they are getting. Because tomorrow our children is going to suffer. You see. So I don't see any reason of saying that Kamwi and Swapo they are together, or Kamwi wants to succeed. Already Swapo shows it's killing, it's destroying this name of Kamwi. Because once you talk about Kamwi, you are sized. Now who is saying I don't like to the other? Who is breaking the marriage? Is it Kamwi or Swapo? It's Swapo. For the thing that you asked, that are you going to succeed in what to achieve what you want to do? Even Swapo, the guns and weapons which were here, which the colonial had been using, they were big guns. But today we are talking about the independence of Southwest. They left. It is easy. It's very hard to start something. But people, if they have determination, they can achieve what they want. The problem is only us, people are divided. This one is a Mafwe, that one is a Subia, that one is a Mayeyi, all that. That is the problem of us. But if the people come together, sit on the table, and see what is coming to them, everything could be achieved.
See, the problem, I will raise a question, even though I wanted to hear from the president also. Maybe you can also answer it. The question is this: you said your party is not for secession. So what more if Swapo saying no, we won't agree, as already they are silent, what will you do? In exception of United Nations, because the United Nations, they have to wait until when they receive bloodshed, is when they will come.
No, they will not wait for that.
So what will you do? Are you not going to fight?
No. I've told you that 1980...
You are talking to someone is silent.
Yes, I will answer.
What will you do?
The war ended 1989, ceasefire was signed. You see, we have legal instruments here like courts. We have courts here. And I'm sure that as we have put our case before United Nations. They are attending to it urgently. We are waiting as we are sitting here. We have already received a message that they will get a date within 15 August and 30 October. Between these days, they will get a date to go and give us a feedback of what the UN Security Council has said on the issue.
Okay.
You understand, Privy? That CANU has already rested physical fighting. It's rested. It's done, finished 1989. Here, we are going to handle everything peacefully. Peacefully. And it will happen. We don't care. We know that in the process, we are victimized. We know that in the process, we are tortured. If you are taken away from the job, you are tortured. Even though I'm above 60, I could still continue feeding my children. You understand? But now my children, who is feeding them? No one. You see? That is torture. That is torture. Even though I'm not in prison, but I'm in prison psychologically. That is torture. Yeah, that is torture. You see? So, once you talk of me, it's not new to me, my brother. It's not new. This type of
things. Were you arrested or they were just only suspended or dismissed? Suspension and dismissal are different things.
My friend, some of the things that I have to talk about, but I have to talk about them. No matter how painful they
are. This is a time to talk.
You see, I want to tell you that when I left this country being an executive member of the head was Thomas Kwala, the one who died. And he was followed by one certain Andrew Sumbari, he said Mukalo. And I was part of that. And the late Rex Mumbone and Moise Buchale were part of that. It is here where there is a post office here. That part, that building was still a legislative assembly. That is where Thomas Kwala, I myself, Andrew Sumbari, Moise Buchale, and Rex Mumbone refused to talk to DTA because we did not receive an instruction from Dr. Sekinoma and Mr. Myongo in exile that we should talk to them. We refused, here. We refused. And after that, the Boers now took a step to try to arrest me and all those things, because I had also some records of dispatching students from Sancho Secondary School. I dispatched 4 groups. And all these groups, I was supposed to go to them, but they were leaving me. And when they leave a list, and my name is there. Can see how difficult it was. When I left this country in 1977, I went in exile. 1978 October, I was arrested on the allegations that I was the leader of CANU at the front. Here. They were saying I was the leader of CANU. They are mobilizing soldiers like a previous year. I was detained from October, November, December, January, February, March. You understand? I'm a man with a group of Caprivians. Some of them are alive. That case, when I was released in March, I went to Angola. But before we traveled to Angola, I reported that case to the late Mazazi, who reported it to Mr. Michel Muyongo. And Mr. Michel Muyongo called the deputy army commander immediately. And the next morning we were put together and he was warned. I went to Angola. In Angola, I was also arrested after the training. Because from the front we were going for the training in Anyeko. And after that, after the training, I went in the brigade. And in the brigade, I was a commander there, one of the commanders, but I was arrested. In the pretext of other things, but the main issue was that I was the leader of CANU. Because when other Caprivians come and visit me, they think we are holding meetings. And in 1983,
you were arrested by here or Swapo?
I was in exile. plan.
Plan, yes. I'm talking about plan, not here.
Well, you were
yes, so. I'm telling you that. I'm telling you that in 1978 I was detained. Because I was suspected to be a leader of CANU.
Okay.
Party. You understand?
Mm.
But at the front, I never held any single meeting of CANU or SWAPO. Mm. Because there is no time. We are just fighting all the time. In Angola, I was also arrested in 1981.
Mm-hmm.
In 1983, I was removed from the brigade. I was sent first, next year, when you cross Kavango River, there's an area there. I was in exile. There was a company there with a 10th battalion. I was sent there.
In Angola?
In Angola.
Kalai, that side.
Those sides of Kalai, yes.
Okay.
And then I stayed there for a month. I was recalled again. Then I was sent to the Northern Front. I went to the Northern Front. I went on a mission, but I got sick. On the way to Namibia, I got sick because I had a problem of lungs. My lungs were totally finished. I started coughing blood. Then I went back to Angola and it was time of offensive, but God protected until I arrived. I stayed in the hospital from 1984 up to, I think it was 1984 June, up to 1985 January. I was discharged. And when I was discharged, the doctor said, no, this man is no more fit for military services. The military council of plant appointed me to be in Rwanda as a national chief of personnel, national chief of personnel for the SWAPO logistics. I stayed there only for 5 months, 85, July, 31st July, I was recalled. And when I was recalled, only to come and be interrogated, that was an interrogation. Because by then, the late Comrade Kapero was now demoted from being a secretary for defense, and the others were already arrested. Then I was also interrogated as one of the leaders of CANU. I have to defend myself. Yeah. So I want to tell you that it is not easy, and it's not for the first time for me to experience these type of things. You understand? I've experienced them all over. All those ways I've passed, yeah, I've experienced them. So, even though I was not in the dungeons, but it's like I was under house arrest myself, because wherever I go, I'm wanted.
Anyway, tell us what led to your suspension here.
What led to my suspension is simply being a leader of CANU. But I can tell you that there is no provision in the constitution of the association that says a leader of the association should not be a leader of a political party, or a leader of the association should not publish any writing of any kind, any political writing of any kind. There is nothing. Or a provision that says when a leader of the association becomes a leader of a political party, he's regarded to have automatically resigned. There is nothing. So how do you charge a person? And to that extent, we had a resolution that if we are not busy, we are free to do other types of work that we feel we can do. So how do you suspend a person in that situation? It's politically motivated.
I think even the constitution is not yet approved.
It's politically motivated.
You are working for which
Namibia
association?
The National Liberation Veteran Association.
Okay.
Yeah.
What was your position?
I was a vice president there.
Mm.
Yeah, look, that association is my brainchild. Mm. I started that association.
When?
Of course, there were some skirmishes, people grouping themselves here and there. But the person who came with a formidable idea of establishing an association is me in 2006, early 2006. But I knew that I was doing it for.
How did you form it?
Simply, an association just formed. I just called one comrade at John Manette First National Bank.
Okay.
Yeah, I called him. He was passing. I called him. I said, listen, I have an idea of establishing an association for the ex-combatants and war veterans. He said, I'm interested. I asked him, do you know of some other people that we can co-opt, especially women, so that we can balance? He referred me to a certain Rosa Maruru and another one. So the other one was very far. Then we went to Rosa Maruru. We told her our ideas, and she was so interested. Then we established a committee. We started making a research, which led to the creation of the Ministry of Veteran Affairs.
What were you doing before creating such an association?
I had a business, a legal service business,
okay.
Legal service provider business. Look, I'm a legal service provider. I'm completing my LLB degree in law this year.
Okay.
Yeah, even though I'm old. Yeah, I look very nice, very young, but I'm very old. Eh?
What did you do after independence?
What did I do after independence?
Mm.
When I left
1990.
When I left this country, I was a teacher. And when I came back, I continued to be a teacher.
Mm-hmm.
Then I was promoted to senior personnel officer at the head office. I was promoted as a senior personnel officer to head office. I was dealing with the policy formulations in the Ministry of Basic Education and Culture. Then later, I was appointed by State House to establish SIPE, Socioeconomic Integration for Ex-Combatants, both PLAN and SWATF. So we established that company, me and Dilola and the others. I stayed there until 1998 when I started my own business. So,
if you look at the issue of candidate for national unity, I may rightfully say that it was not intended to be a political party as such, but a tool to find out where exactly the Caprivi African National Union was. Right. And then also, if you look at the movement, the journey, the trip, the political travel that we went through, though it was not easy, it was a situation whereby you find that there's been a time when we confronted the Electoral Commission of Namibia to talk about legislation of the Candidate for National Unity, which was supposed to be abbreviated or shortened as CANU part of Namibia, where they said, no, this one cannot be legislated because, the abbreviation is exactly as the very Caprivi African National Union was for the 60s. That was the definite political hunt which we were hunting for. And you find that when I'm talking about this issue, I should not forget about the involvement of Mr. Kapala Benson, who was together with me. But through the process, like what my president said, that's when now we started. When we received the answer from the Electoral Commission of Namibia, we were very busy looking for a leader of the Caprivi African National Union to revive the structure of the Caprivi African National Union. And we came across his name and we said, this is the man who supported me in the forefront of the Caprivi African National Union. It's not something which is should be regarded as an easy issue or an easy task, to fight for CANU, because each time, maybe you rightfully alluded to the fact that when Mr. Lukato wanted to register his Caprivi National Democratic Party, he was told, don't register his Caprivi National Democratic Party because it was going to sound ethnic. So for us to come with the contention, we wanted to remove that issue of ethnic, but less did the ECN, knew that it was a political ambush. They gave us what we wanted. They told us that CANU was there rightfully, resulting in swap. For us, it was good. And that's why we said, fine, let's continue with the structure of CANU, Caprivi African National Union. Right. And also on the issue of does there exist a merger between CANU and SWAPO?
Yes, the major is there. Look, the ECN pointed out to the major. You see now, the documents are there. We have got letters signed by ECN, number one. Number two, if you read this book, To Be Born a Nation, which was published by SWAPO, the arm of information and publicity, page 176, it says Caprivi African National Union merged with SWAPO. Read Where Others Were But, it talks about the same story. Read Libertina Madela's book, it talks about the same story. Read all the historical books which are being started and led by our learners in schools. It talks about whatever. So now, where can these people say there was no major? The major was there, and the major is still there, it still stands, because there are no documents up to now which cancels the major. Because the major is still there. That's why Kadeja Financial Unity was not registered, because there was already an existence between SWAPO and KANU as two merged parties, like what my president said. So now, also, if you look at what we are trying to do at the moment, like we said, that we approach the United Nations. The United Nations is a big body. It has got some instruments. The United Nations is for peace and unity. If you want to fight, you cannot fight the United Nations, because you will never fight any single country, any single nation, whatever. You just have to use the instruments of the United Nations, because these guys are for peace. That's why we wrote several letters to UN to say, UN, please, can you mediate between KANU, Caprivi African National Union, which has got a history for Caprivians as a tool, as an instrument, as a property of Caprivians, between KANU and SWAPO. So we wrote them, you know, a lot of letters. But yeah, SWAPO received letters to State House. UN received the letters. That's why today we are at the point of disputing those political parties. I mean, they have political positions to say. A Prime Minister's position is KANU. Political defense is KANU and whatever. You ask the question, what's going to happen and what are we going to do if these guys resist? Any disputed position, I'll tell you, once we dispute a position, it means, dispute means court action. Once you say disputed, it means court action. Now, like what my president is saying, we are not joking, we are very serious, we have gone for a dispute, we have told the United Nations these positions are disputed, what's going to follow? Now is the court action to say, can those positions be vacated with immediate effect from the 1st of August? All the positions are supposed to be vacated. You see, because any disputed position, there's no one supposed to sit in that position, because it belongs to nobody, unless a decision has been taken, unless a political settlement has been taken, unless, you know, whatever, because there is a major here.